Hello out there. My name is Coda, and I'm a senior engineer for Dell EMC, supporting many of our enterprise platform systems. In this video, I'll be going over the steps to export a Support Assist collection, also known as a TSR or Technical Support Report, from the Lifecycle Controller or LCC. As you can see, we've powered on this system and it's entered the Lifecycle Controller. To begin, we'll want to select Hardware Diagnostics. And from this list, we'll select Export Support Assist Collection. And we'll want to check the box here, just stating that we agree to allow technical support to use the Support Assist Collection information. And click Next. And here are the many different options you can choose as to what you want to include in the TSR. By default, it will select system information. You can also choose storage logs, OS and application data, debug logs, as well as telemetry reports. I'm going to leave those unselected for now and have only system information. And click Next. On this screen, it gives us a few options to choose from as far as where to export the Support Assist collection to. For the purpose of this video, I will be using a USB drive that I have connected to the system. But as you can see below, there are a couple of network options you can choose from. You can use SIFS, NFS, HTTP, or HTTPS. I will leave USB drive selected and leave the file path blank and click Next. This is just a brief summary of my previous selections, and we'll click Finish. This process will take several minutes before it's completed, so we'll go ahead and fast forward. Great, it looks like we have successfully exported our Support Assist report. We will click OK. And it takes us back to the home screen. That's all there is to it, really, as far as exporting the TSR report. Now, a reason for doing this from within the LCC, the iDRAC is the most commonly used tool for gathering Support Assist collections, but if the iDRAC is not accessible or not configured, we may rely on the LCC. This may also be helpful for environments that restrict iDRAC usage. That's all we have for this video. I hope this was helpful, and thank you for watching.